Welcome to Alanis Business Academy. I'm Matt Alanis, and this is How to Calculate the Internal Rate of Return. Often referred to by the acronym IRR, the Internal Rate of Return is a common tool used to assist firms in evaluating various capital budgeting proposals. Put simply, these firms are attempting to determine the best use of their limited resources. Before we calculate the IRR, it's important that you have knowledge of the time value of money as well as how to calculate the net present value. For a refresher on these topics, select the links above and then come back to this video once you feel confident that you could carry out the net present value calculations. IRR is the discount rate that causes the net present value, or NPV, to equal zero. An NPV of zero essentially means that the present value of all future cash flows equals the value of our investment. Put another way, the money that we expect to receive in the future, discounted into today's dollars, equals how much we are investing in this project. By obtaining the IRR of several projects, we can determine which project is more likely to provide a better return. A higher IRR means that we have to discount our future cash flows by a greater interest rate so that they equal our investment. As a result, projects that yield a higher internal rate of return are considered to be more attractive compared to their lower yielding counterparts. In order to calculate the IRR, we need to go through a trial and error process utilizing the present value formula. As an example, let's say that you're planning on investing $5,000 in a project that is expected to produce $2,500 in cash at the end of year one and $3,500 in cash at the end of year two. What is our expected internal rate of return? To answer this question, it helps to first draw out our scenario as follows. Next, we need to select an interest rate that we feel may cause our future cash flows to be worth $5,000 after being discounted. Remember, this is a trial and error process, so don't worry too much about having to repeat the process. Let's start with a discount rate of 9%. At this point, we essentially work through the problem as if we are attempting to determine the NPV. You can either use the present value equation, which is PV equals FV divided by 1 plus I to the nth power, a financial calculator, or software like Microsoft Excel. I'm going to utilize the PV equation. After discounting $2,500 by our discount rate of 9% for 1 year, we receive a present value of $2,293.58 after rounding to the nearest hundredth. After discounting $3,500 by our discount rate of 9% for 2 years, we receive a present value of $2,945.88. Next, we add both figures together to get $5,239.46. Since our discounted future cash flows are $5,239.46 and our investment is $5,000, an IRR of 9% gives us an NPV of $239.46, which of course is greater than zero. A positive NPV tells us that we need a higher discount rate to lower the present value of our future cash flows. So let's select a higher discount rate. For our next calculation, let's use a discount rate of 12%. Once again, I'm going to draw out our scenario and then use the present value equation to discount our future cash flows. $2,500 discounted by our discount rate of 12% for 1 year gives us a present value of $2,232.14, rounded to the nearest hundredth. $3,500 discounted by our discount rate of 12% for 2 years gives us a present value of $2,790.18, rounded to the nearest hundredth. Adding these two figures together gives us a total present value of $5,022.32. This is very close to our investment of $5,000 and would result in an NPV of only $22.32. Although this isn't zero, what this tells us is that we're only fractions of a percent away from our true IRR. You can continue to go through this trial and error process to obtain the exact IRR if you wish. Using a financial calculator, which is far less time consuming, we receive an IRR of 12.32%. This has been How to Calculate the Internal Rate of Return. If you have any questions or comments, please leave them in the comment box below, and I'll do my best to get back to those in a timely fashion. For access to additional videos on finance, as well as other business topics, please be sure to subscribe to Alanis Business Academy, and also remember to like and share this video with your friends. Thanks for watching.